and pull down, be reached down in your child addiction. And pull down.
Yeah.
If he got the power to pull me out, that means I got the power to sustain myself while I'm in.
Thank you, God.
And see, that's why I got a few people in here that praise God in their mental medication. That's what you're talking about. See, some people understand. I know I'm going through what I'm going through right now, but I'm going to praise God while I'm in this situation. Because if God got the power to pull me out of this mess, then I got the power to sustain while I'm in it. And see, that's why people don't understand how you made it this far in your life. They know in a bad financial situation, but God's sustaining you while you're in it. People know you're sick in your body, but you still got a smile on your face. God is sustaining you while you're in it. There needs some real people in the middle to thank God right now. That I'm in some stuff right now, but He's been sustaining me.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank
you,
God. Hallelujah. And this is where our text fits like a puzzle. Let's go back to my text. It says, wherever you go,
yeah,
and whatever you do, you will be blessed.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this is not for the people who play games with their tithes and their offerings.
Yeah.
This is not for the people who are not faithfully committed to God. No, no, no. This is not for people who just come to church because it's the only thing to do on Sunday. But it's for the people who really believe God for real. Who have a real relationship with God.
Yeah.
Who have a real commitment to God.
Yeah.
Wherever you go.
Yeah.
And whatever you do.
Yeah.
You will be blessed. Somebody how wherever you go.
Wherever you go.
So basically that means if I go to the bank tomorrow, something is unexpected. Has a potential to be deposited in my bank account. Tell me how, wherever you go. So that means if I go on my next interview, they're going to beg me to take the job. Tell me how, wherever you go. When I go to the doctor next, my next appointment, and they read me my test results, they're going to tell me they can't find nothing wrong in my body. I need somebody to run out to thank God. But the next place I go, wherever my feet strong, the power of God going to follow me. Because I was in Walmart the other day, and you've probably seen it before yourself. Go to the cash register, myself. And the cash register lady had on gloves. I said, ma'am, why you got gloves on? She said, look at how much dirt is on my hands. You have no idea how much stuff I touched in one day.
Yeah.
You missed your shot, cute. She says, I touched so much stuff that dirt and filth accumulate on my hands on a daily basis. So I gotta put gloves on my hands. Because I touched so much stuff in my bank. Don't even talk to me. God told me to tell you. And everything your hand touched, God said, I'm gonna bless it. When I touch my wallet, it's gonna be blessed. When I touch my gas tank, it's gonna be blessed. When I touch my refrigerator, it's about to be blessed. When I touch my steering wheel, it's gonna be blessed.
Yeah.
God says, whatever I'm in, you anyway. I don't know if I'm talking to you here, but somebody here this afternoon wants to thank God in here. That God's got the power to bless me while I'm in my situation.
Thank you, Lord.
And I don't know who I'm talking to this afternoon, but somebody in here wants to thank God this afternoon. That I might be in a storm in my life. I might be faced with raging seas in my life. But God told me to tell you that no matter what you need, I'm going to make things work out in your favor. And if anybody in here wants to thank God, I'm in some stuff right now. But I believe with everything in my spirit that God will reach down and pull me out of what I'm in. And if anybody in the building wants to thank God, I'm not going to let what I'm in stop my worship.
Yeah.